Welcome, gang, to Hildegarde's Radio Room. To the music of Harry Sosnick and his orchestra, our special guests of the evening. There goes the spotlight, and here she comes, our vivacious star, the incomparable Hildegarde.
Let's get together for a while. Don't mind the weather, you can smile. Get in good condition, just relax and have some fun. Every inhibition you can tear down, let your hair down. Loosen up and grin a little grin. Give the sun a doorway to get in. Like a daisy you'll be perking, your sense of humor's working. So gather round and have a little fun. Come on everybody, loosen up and grin a little grin, that's it. Give the sun a doorway to get in. Like a daisy you'll be perking, your sense of humor's working. So gather round and have a little fun.
Thank you and good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
My, there are celebrities here tonight from so many fields, like music, films, radio, sports, mystery. Why, it's a regular field day. Harry, a little walking music, please. Let's see how everybody feels. Well, good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Ewald of Detroit. And hello, Commissioner, back again. Good. And look who's hiding behind that mountain of marshmallow ice cream. It's Jackie Kelk, known to his radio fans as Homer. Everybody! Good evening, Jackie.
Good evening, Hildegarde.
You know, it's rather unusual to see one so young in the Raleigh Room.
Well, it's this way, Hildegarde. This afternoon, the fellas in my school voted for the girl we'd most like to be shipwrecked with. In the gymnasium.
Oh, did I get any vote?
Oh, I'll say. You came in second. Shirley Temple was third. Of course, she's pretty old.
Yes, I know. Poor old Shirley. But who was first?
Miss Hermina Sprackle.
I never heard of her. She must be very beautiful.
No, she's our geometry teacher, and we all want to pass.
Well, I'm a little jealous of Miss Sprackle, all you boys wanting to be stranded with her on a desert island.
Well, it wouldn't be much fun, but we learn an awful lot of geometry.
I see your point. Especially if... Oh, Jackie, please excuse me. Someone just came in whose presence cannot be ignored. Why, that tall, handsome, sensational gentleman is Hank Greenberg. Come on, everybody, let's get the hero. Excuse me, Hank. Now is my turn at bat. Harry, if you please. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to sing a beautiful new ballad from the pen of Sammy Fain, the composer of I'll Be Seeing You. Incidentally, it's from the hit picture Weekend at the Waldorf and is called And There You Are. Though we are oceans apart, you're never out of my heart. I simply close my eyes and there you are. There in the dawn's early light, there in the still of the night, I look behind a star and there you are. Whenever there's a storm, I don't even hear the thunder. My heart with love is so aflame, I only hear each little raindrop repeating your name. And when the long day is through, I long for you, only you. Then I pretend you're there, and there you are. Whenever there's a storm, I don't even hear the thunder.
My heart with love is so aflame. I only hear each little raindrop repeating your name. And when the long day is through, I long for you, only you. Then I pretend you're there, and there you
One of Irving Berlin's most romantic ballads is the ever-beautiful How Deep Is the Ocean, and I would like to sing it for you right now. How much do I love you? I'll tell you no lie. How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? Of you, how many roses are sprinkled with dew? How far would I travel to be where you are? How far is the journey? From here to a star. And if I ever lost you, how much would I cry? How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? How far would I travel to be where you are? How far is the journey from here to a star? And if I ever lost you, how much would I cry? How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky?
Ladies and gentlemen, now before I go any further, there's a man over there who's had his back to me all evening, and I'll have to put a stop to that. Oh, sir, your eyes aren't in the right place.
Where do you want them, under my nose?
Why, it's somebody I know very well. It's a unique screen personality, one of the finest gentlemen, our dearly beloved.
I ain't dead yet.
It's Ned Spark. Mr. Sparks, do you realize you've been sitting through the whole show without even smiling? Why do you frown?
I had an awful nightmare last night. I dreamt I was happy.
Oh, you poor man. Something must be done about you. I know what. I'll tell you one of my extra special jokes.
Do you have to?
Of course. Here it is. Do you know why our waiters like to serve asparagus? Because asparagus tips. I pulled a joke.
Push it back.
Well, I'm not through yet. I'm going to make you happy tonight, even if I have to fall back on last year's repertoire. Uh-huh. I don't know what to do. What will I do? Hank Greenberg, do you see that man over there? Well, that is Ned Sparks, the actor. He hasn't smiled all evening.
An actor? He looks more like an umpire.
Well, I'm not giving up yet. And Hank, you know, there's a young boy here tonight. I'm sure will be thrilled to meet you. May I take you over to him?
Well, sure thing.
Oh, Jackie Kelk. Jackie, this is Hank Greenberg.
Oh, boy. Hank Greenberg. I'll remember this moment forever. Just like the time I gave Stinky Cooper a bloody nose.
Ah, he sure reminds me of my own kid days.
Gosh, were you ever a kid?
Sure. I can just hear my mother now calling me from a baseball game. Henry! Henry Greenberg!
Sure, and I can just hear you yelling back, "Not coming, Mother."
Well, right now, my dinner is calling me. Will you excuse me?
Of course, Hank.
Oh, gosh, Hank Greenberg. Gee, I wish my girl Veronica was here.
Veronica? Oh, what a nice name. What is she like?
Oh, she's beautiful, Hildegarde. She's one of twins.
Really? How do you tell them apart?
It's easy. Her brother has a mustache. Consulted me today.
How come?
Well, she said any woman would go to the end of the world for Van Johnson. So I said, what about me? She said, you're the reason they never come back.
Well, Jackie, maybe you don't know how to handle girls. You see, you should do something romantic, like taking a hansom cab through Central Park with the moon overhead and the fragrant flowers in the air.
Oh, I tried that. I didn't think it was so romantic.
Well, maybe you weren't with the right girl.
Oh, you have to be with somebody?
Oh, Jackie, you're wonderful. You know, it's such an exciting evening, and there are so many marvelous people here that all I can think of is you. Gee, but you're wonderful, you. Lovely you. You completely satisfy. I'm confessing that is why there's nobody like you. You. So much depends upon you. Tell me true. Will it be my fate at all? Will I ever rate at all with somebody like you? Just to think that you love me makes my future look strong. I swear by stars above me, I'm darned if I don't feel like writing a song about you. Music and words about you, lovely you. Let me think of phrases for, let me sing out phrases for nobody but you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, now I have an announcement. If any one of you is murdered here tonight, don't worry. We've got someone here who'll be able to tell you who did it. It's Claudia Morgan and Les Tremaine, radio's famous Mr. and Mrs. Thin Man, Nick and Nora Childs. Harry, take me over. Good evening, Nick and Nora. Had any good murders, lately?
Well, Hildegarde, there was a juicy one Saturday night and a rather sordid one last night.
Last night? Why, last night we went to the opera.
Yes, that was murder.
And Nick, tell me, you always get your man, but how do you do it?
Oh, it's very simple. Now, you take that third violinist over there, that one, the one who forgot his hair, isn't she? Suppose he was murdered here tonight. The first thing I'd do would be to...
Order a martini.
Very dry, no olive.
But what about the poor violinist?
Well, after the martini, I'd have the waiter remove the violinist.
Oh, yes. An orchestra looks so sloppy with a dead violinist.
Then I'd order another martini.
And while you're drinking, won't the murderer get away?
Oh, by that time, Nicky doesn't care.
Why, do so. The reason I'm drinking is because I know who did it all along.
Who?
The drummer.
But how do you know?
Well, you see, the drummer uses sticks to beat a hide. Mr. Hyde is Dr. Jekyll's alter ego. An altar is where you get married. The drummer is married, therefore he hates his wife.
Naturally.
He met his wife through a violinist, so he hates all violinists. The dead man is a violinist, so the drummer killed him. Waiter, another martini.
Oh, Nick, that was brilliant. And only five martinis.
Give him a quart and he'll kill off the whole orchestra.
It'll be a pleasure. Hildegarde. Do you know this gentleman who's coming to this table?
No, I don't believe so.
Hildegarde, this is Paul McGrath. He's radio's horror man. You know, the host of Inner Sanctum.
Well, Mr. McGrath, I'm delighted to see you. I've heard you so often. But there's something I'm very curious about. Would you open your mouth slowly?
Why?
I want to hear your famous creaking jaw.
Hildegarde, that's a creaking door.
Well, what's the difference? Just so it creaks. Paul, aren't you frightened by all of those horrible things that happen in your presence?
Oh, you mean those pleasant little incidents like bats howling in the night and the wild shrieks of ghouls and banshees? No, no, my dear girl. Nothing ever scares me. Nothing. Oh, by the way, Hildegarde, you serve blood here.
Ooh, it's getting cold. Oh, Paul, something just occurred to me. You see, Ned Sparks has been sitting frozen-faced all evening. Maybe you can frighten him into showing some life.
Life? What's that?
Yes, indeed. You're just the man. Would you step over to his table with me,
sure.
Please? Good. Mr. Sparks, this is Paul McGrath. Go ahead, Paul. Scare him. Look him straight in the eye.
Leave him to me. I'll give him the silent stare. Boo.
Oh, this is horrible. Take this man away.
He's ghastly. I'm going back to my bets and banshees. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
Nice fellow, but he's a little nervous.
Dear, I thought surely that would work on Mr. Sparks, but still no smile. But I know what. Harry! Harry Sausnick!
Come in, Hildegarde!
Oh. Your voice is changing. Adolescent. Oh, Harry.
<What?
laughs> I said adolescent. Harry, listen to me. I'd like to sing something nice and intimate that will warm Mr. Sparks from his head to his toes.
You don't want a song. You want a hot water bottle.
Well, and we'll have a soft blue spotlight on Mr. Sparks. Spotlight, please. That's it. Thank you.
It's so dark in here, I can't see what I'm eating. And maybe it's better that way.
All right, Harry. Nice and intimate. Are you having any fun, Ned? What you getting out of living? What good is what you've got if you're not having any fun? Are you having any laughs? Are you getting any loving? If other people do, so can you have a little fun? After the honey's in the comb, little bees go out and play. Even the old gray mare at home has got to have hay. Better have a little fun. You're not going to live forever before you're old and gray and still okay. Have a little fun, son. Have a little fun. Why do you work and slave and save? Life is full of ifs and buts. You know squirrels save and save. And what have they got?
No.
Better have a little fun. You're not going to live forever before you're old and gray and still okay. Have your little fun, son. Have your little fun. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry. I would like to sing a song, but I think I forgot my words. Oh, no, I think I've got them right now. I'm sorry to say, for a moment, I was a little nervous. Now, the song is a very lovely new ballad, which is daily gaining in popularity, called Counting the Days. Counting the days until tomorrow, counting the nights till I'm with you, slow.
they hurry by, no need to worry. I tell my heart we're only a few lonely nights apart. Counting the stars, I hear you whisper, darling, count on my love to see you through. Blue are the skies above, sweet are my thoughts of love. It's just a matter of time till I'm counting the days with you. Counting the stars, I hear you whisper, darling, count on my love to see you through. Blue are the skies above, sweet are my thoughts of love. It's just a matter of time till I'm counting the days with you.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, I was all prepared to sing Darling, Je Vous Aime Beaucoup there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the reason for that wonderful sparkle of gay Vienna in the room tonight is that enchanting conductor-composer, the great Sigmund Romberg. Mr. Romberg, an ardent admirer, invites you to the center of the floor. Please. Thank you. Mr. Romberg, you're looking wonderful.
It's true.
It's true. And I want to tell you how very much I've enjoyed your summer radio show, An Evening with Romberg.
And I want to tell you how much I would enjoy an evening with Hildegarde.
Now. Mr. Romberg, you've had such a wonderful musical career. Tell us, what is the one most important thing we should all know about music?
Well, the most important thing that every music lover should know is that starting tomorrow night, the marvelous radio program, An Evening with Romberg, will come back.
It's true?
It's true.
Ah, we'll all be listening, my dear Mr. Romberg. But since you're here, wouldn't you like to meet some of our fine musicians?
Musicians? Bah. I want to meet Hank Greenberg.
Oh, no sooner said than done. Hank, step up to the plate, please. Thank you. Mr. Romberg, this is Hank Greenberg.
Mr. Greenberg, I wanted to tell you how much I appreciate those fine things you did for me.
Really? I don't think we've ever met.
I know. But last week, I bet on the Tigers.
Well, I owe you a lot, too, Mr. Romberg. I spent plenty of wonderful nights singing all your songs to my girl.
Singing all my songs? What did she like best?
When I stopped.
Oh, you know, you two are very, very funny. Maybe you could cheer Mr. Sparks. That's an idea. Mr. Sparks, be a good sport and come up to the floor. You know, I thought it would make you happy to meet two such important people.
Why?
Why? Because they're very interesting. They're amusing.
Well, amuse me.
Go on, boys. Boys, do something. Amuse him.
Which one is Costello?
Well, Hank, we didn't do so good. It's true?
It's true.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you anyway, gentlemen. Oh, I know, Jackie Kelk. Jackie, maybe you could make Mr. Sparks smile. Would you come up, please? Hurry.
Oh, gee, Mr. Sparks. How would you like to entertain at our Halloween party? You'd be perfect for scaring girls.
What apple did he crawl out of?
Gosh, if I don't get some entertainment, Miss Sprackle will be awful mad.
Miss who?
Sprackle, Sprackle, Sprackle.
Sounds like he's laying an egg. Funniest thing I've heard in years.
Why, Ned Sparks, you're actually smiling. Oh, thank you, Jackie, for helping me do the impossible. And thank you, Ned, for being yourself.
I loved it, Hildegarde. All night on the inside, I've been going, ha-ha. Even though on the outside, it's been going, eh.
Yes. Thank you. Well, that puts me in just the mood for the grand finale. I have a Harry Sosnick arrangement of a charming Sigmund Romberg melody from way up in Central Park called It Doesn't Cost You Anything to Dream. It doesn't cost you anything to dream. You buy the world at night. The price is always right at night. You're wealthy, you're attractive, you're supreme. The sun and moon are cheap. As long as you're asleep, they're cheap. Awake, your arms are empty. Asleep, your lips have met. Unless you have insomnia, there is no one you can't get. It doesn't cost you anything to dream. A dream will always be the only thing that's free for you, for me. Awake, your arms are empty. Asleep, your lips have met. Unless you have insomnia, there is no one you can't get. It doesn't cost you anything to dream. A dream will always be the only thing that's free. Boys and girls, that does it for this evening. And now this is Hildegarde saying thank you and a good, good night wherever you are. Goodbye and God bless you all.
Darling Hildegarde came to you from New York. This is the Armed Forces Radio Service.
Happy day, toodle-loodle-loodle-loodle-loodle-ay, for you and me, for us and we, all the clouds have rolled away. It's a happy day, toodle-loodle-loodle-loodle-loodle-ay, the sun shines bright and the world's all right. It's a happy day. 24 sunbeams are dancing round my face. 24 more are dancing every place. It's a happy day. Toodle loodle 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 loodle. You can't go wrong if you sing a song. It's a happy day. 24 sunbeams are dancing round my face. 24 more are dancing.